headquarters. We have a full-size Hot Wheels fleet. It's our 50th anniversary.
That's right.
And we're kicking off a one-of-a-kind, once-in-a-lifetime Legends Tour, Hot Wheels Legends Tour.
Right.
So this is the first stop.
Right. It's going to, what, 14 places all around the
14
country?
14 different Walmart parking lots, actually.
Every Walmart parking lot is different. Believe me. You want to talk the whole set. It's unbelievable. Some are concrete, some are asphalt. It's unbelievable.
They are.
If you collect Walmart parking lots, this is the tour of the century.
The stripes.
That's right, the stripes.
Got the stripes.
And there's RVs across the street. It's unbelievable.
I mean, what's cool about this one is, and why there's such great variety out here, is that we are looking for the next Hot Wheels. What does that mean? So at each of the 14 locations, including today's kickoff, we are going to be selecting one car at every location. And all of those cars are going to be a total of 15 that we select plus one that we bring, total of 16, at SEMA in Vegas in October.
Right.
We're going to choose one of those cars to be the next Hot Wheels diecast toy.
Yeah, I think that's a great idea. And everybody has a shot because there's really no, like I say, just because you have a really expensive exotic car, but it might not be as interesting as some of the Hot Rod. I mean, I've seen cars out there, people go for like $100, and they're just as interesting as you know, the high-end stuff. I was talking to a gentleman who's got a Hot Rod had built in Japan, but it's a traditional American Hot Rod with a little Japanese influence. That's what's great about California. It's so multicultural. You get all kinds of different feels and looks to things, so that's what makes it great fun.
That's right. And it's those nuances and those flavors. I mean, what we're looking for is what actually looks authentically like a Hot Wheels. You look at it and you say, you know what, that is a Hot Wheels.
Right.
We're also, to your point, we're looking for originality. What hasn't been done maybe in that way before? And then we're looking for, like the guy that you were talking to with his Japanese influenced American Hot Rod, we're looking for people that have the garage spirit, that have kind of like wrenched themselves, built themselves on a great story to tell.
Well, I always call it the rattle cannon. Whenever I come to the shows, I like to try and find the man or woman who kind of did the car themselves. How much money you spend? You know, maybe they painted it with a Rust-Oleum can and rubbed it down in their own garage at home. You know, to me that says a lot more than you send it out to an expensive paint shop and have it done. You know, because you can look at the workmanship and see, and that's what makes it really, really interesting.
You can see the creativity in the story, and great value and amazing design does not have to come in a super expensive package. In fact, Hot Wheels is one of the greatest values at $1 still.
It's only $1, really.
What could go wrong?
Yeah.
And the greatest variety is something for everyone. So.
Yeah, and if your car is chosen, you'll get one free Hot Wheel. So that's pretty good. That's a $1 value. That's
inexpensive, but highly valuable.
Yeah.
So look, it's our 50th anniversary. I understand that it's on a very important anniversary today as well. Okay. It's Hot Wheels' birthday, but it's also your birthday.
Well, it is my birthday. It is my birthday. Be chosen. Just think, if your car is chosen, some kid somewhere will strap an M80 to it, roll it down the hill, and blow it. Yeah, so that's it.
Challenge.
I'm going to get that one. You know you've done it. You've all done it. Roll it down the hill, blow it up. It's a no way, right over.
Blue on it, right on fire.
Like Doritos, we make more. Just keep making them. There's only 4 billion. There are more Hot Wheels than there are real cars. You know
that? That is true.
There's 4 billion Hot Wheels.
So, excuse us.
25,000 different variants since 1968.
Yeah.
And we 16 and a half a second.
I was telling you before, in 1968, I worked at McDonald's. And the slogan of McDonald's 1968 was where a family of four can have lunch for under $1. Hamburgers are 15 cents a piece, so you got 4 hamburgers for 60 cents, fries are 15, and a large Coke. And you got change back.
Yep.
And
I wouldn't like that now.
No.
You're going to pay $10 to $12 for it.
Yeah.
And Hot Wheels, and by the way, unlike that McDonald's meal, Hot Wheels last forever.
Right.
Lifetime guarantee. Payback. It's tough. So look, to celebrate your birthday, on our birthday,
right,
we have a couple of special gifts for you.
Oh, yeah. All right.
So this is actually one of a kind, made in our model shop. You can open it later. You don't have to open it now. I think it's
open it. I not want to open it now.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I'll open it in a month.
Look at this.
Oh, very cool. Yeah, look at this.
Yeah, get a shot. Which car is that?
This may be its global debut.
Okay.
So it's a spoiler. Media shut it down. This is the H-W-50. This is a collectively designed car by our own very talented design team.
Cool thing I like about the Hot Wheels. It kind of reminds me of the iPhone. Remember when the iPhone came out? How much better it felt in your hand than a regular phone? This felt better made. And that was the cool thing about these. These always have those really, most toy cars have a, you know, like a paper type of hand. Whereas these actually have bearings in the wheels, so they actually fold, which really make it kind of cool.
This was the magic formula that Elliot Handler really introduced with his creative team back in 1968. And it was the performance as well as the incredible design that I think caused it to last a lot of time. So, look, we also got you a lunchbox.
Oh, now that's good.
It doesn't have to all the time.
I don't really eat Hot Wheels, but I would love that.
With this, you can open later. It's got a few of your favorites that relate to
all of your stuff. I don't have to open them later. Oh, and next year on your birthday, you can open them. I should.
All right.
Can you help me see what this is?
There you go.
What
we got here?
Thumbs up. I used to have a Meet the Press lunchbox. Wow, a box with two holes in it.
Very unique. But this one is actually from 1968.
Oh, is that right?
This is an original.
So oh, very cool.
Don't need it.
No, I won't.
Worth more than a Big Mac.
Yeah, that's worth it. No, that's very cool.
So, look, Jay, in wrapping this up so we can go look at some cars, I want to thank you.
I don't have time for another gift.
From the Hot Wheels team, what we love about the partnership that we've had with you in the past, and I mean, you've driven the door to two, you've driven the Vader car, we've done interviews, we've discussed.
Well, that's what I like. You guys build real cars.
We build real cars, and we love real cars. You can see it, our talented design team has their cars lined up down the center strip of this. Those are their own cars. They're building them. So on this, our 50th anniversary of birthday, we love have somebody that has the same kind of challenging spirit that this brand is and appreciates the brand and variety and what it does for
us. I have been around for 50 years, so there you go.
Hey, look, this is 50 years we're doing something.
I worked at McDonald's, the minimum wage was a Hot Wheel an hour. That's what it was. I got one Hot Wheel an hour.
Well, Jay, thank you very much. Really appreciate it.
Well, thanks, everybody. Very cool. Thanks. Let's see how you can start. Good. Cool. See you guys in a bit.